This is what the area looks like just outside of Baker. This big valley. Back there is Baker. Now, these mountains look like they were pushed up, and if you look at them from satellite or from an airplane, they look like islands, and the sediment below looks like water. That's a creosote bush there. But the mountains on the other side look like they got pushed up after the sediment was deposited and pushed the sediment up with it. Like the mountains in LA near the tar pits, it shows there was some upwarping of the Pleistocene material, which means the mountains were rising at the time of the Pleistocene, it was after the flood. See the upwarping of the strata as these mountains were upthrust, carrying the sediment up with it as it rose. Now the sediment I'm talking about is a post-flood quaternary. This is a Pliocene-Pleistocene material in these valleys. Is not connected to the Mesozoic or the Paleozoic. Those strata are sometimes in the mountains that upthrust, like the Cambrian, which is Paleozoic. Notice the different types of mountains and different types of strata that have been up-pushed all around this area. Each mountain is different. Looks like it's a different type of strata. Now you see this valley below us here. That's a dry lake bed. That sediment was deposited in the bottom.
switching that stuff.
These are all stromatolite layers. And there's cert. Now you can see that this has been up thrust and has tilted at an angle. And you can see the cracks in this rock here. This is very hard material, but you can see there are lots of cracks due to the up thrusting. And in this, I found some of these. These are pieces of iron. This is volcanic. And this is cert, and it's very hard, but you can see that it has a lot of cracks in it due to the up thrusting. This is talc. This is an old lake bed, but it looks very much like the Chinle Formation.
After a quarter of a mile,
which contains dinosaur bones. This is an old lake bed. Pleistocene Lake. You can see the volcanic mountains behind. This was the mammoth found in the lake bed here.
Mammoth tribes.
Of the mountains that contain the trilobites. First one to find one right about there. Let's see. No, actually, I found it up here. Thank you. Now this is where the trilobites are up there, and we're coming down the road the other way, which I showed you as we were coming into this canyon. Now we're going out of the canyon down towards the valley. Here's that lake bed, Pleistocene lake bed. With a strata, and it is slightly tilted, which means it has been upthrust. But you can see all this here is salt. That indicates that it's marine. Now we're looking the other direction. See the layering in the rock in these lake deposits. Also notice the upwarping along these mountains as they rose, bringing up the alluvium with them. Notice how the strata, the sediment, is pushed up along this mountain. But when you look at the other mountains across the way, it's different. Now these are older. You can see that by how they are so eroded. And notice the flat sediment below the mountains there. There's no up push like there is in the mountains I just showed you. Now over here you see more mountains, different kind, but you don't see any up pushing of the sediment rising up with the mountain. Now with this, you can see the uprising of the where the sediment has been pulled up by the mountains, as opposed to those on the other side, in the other direction.